Come on now.
Glad I got Jesus. It's my home.
glad I got Jesus down in my heart. God is a good God, and he's worthy to be praised. Sound like somebody glad they got Jesus. Said it sound like somebody glad they got Jesus. If you got Jesus, if you got Jesus, if you got Jesus, he's a mighty good doctor, he's a mighty good friend, he's a lawyer in the courtroom, doctor in the sick room. Glad I got Jesus. If you got Jesus, he's a rocker in the sick room. If you got Jesus, he's a ladder in the courtroom.
I got Jesus.
If you got Jesus,
don't forget. Glad I got Jesus. Anybody got Jesus? Or he's a lawyer in the courtroom. Lawyer in the courtroom. I got Jesus. I got Jesus. He's a doctor in the sick room. I got Jesus. He's a doctor in the sick room. I got Jesus. He's a preacher in the pulpit. I got Jesus. Glad I got Jesus. Oh, I'm glad I got Jesus in my heart. Come on now.
Oh. I was down in the valley one day to pray, and I couldn't hear nobody.
Yeah. All right.
It's all right. It's okay. You got to believe.
Listen. Paul says, I press towards the mark, because while living over there in Rome in Philippi, Paul would Deacon Woolley would go to the Olympic Games. Y'all do know the Olympics, where they would have different gladiators and things like that, and they were all running for one prize, is to get a wreath around their head. You missed it already. They ran the race to get a wreath around their head. I'm running the race to get a crown on my head. Ain't nobody talking to me. So Paul, he would watch those gladiators and how they would strive to work out, how they would strive to be the best. And I'm asking somebody, have you decided to be the best this year? I want to be the best Christian. So that means while I'm trying to be the best Christian, I got to take some stuff off. Ain't nobody talking to me. You got to learn how to take some stuff off.
Okay.
I ran track in middle school. Now, track is different from basketball. Basketball, you would be ashamed to have on them little shorts. See how y'all hung up on me? In basketball, you ain't gonna put on those little shorts. But in track, you want the tightest t-shirt, the shortest shorts. Ain't nobody talking to me. Because you don't want the wind to put resistance. Come on, talk to me if you can. And as Christians, you gotta learn how to take some people off, because they're gonna be the resistance of keeping you get to the prize. Baby, I know we've been friends for a long time, but I gotta put you off. Baby, I know we've been dating for 3 years, but I gotta put you off. Ain't nobody talking to me. I know, but I gotta put you off, because you put resistance on my wall. Why you got your New Year's resolution? You ought to go through your Facebook and through your phone and just start deleting some folks off, saying, baby, this ain't personal, this just business. Ain't nobody talking to me. You got to tell some folks, it ain't personal, it's just business, because I'm trying to get closer to God. And if you ain't trying to push me, get out of my way. That's why grandmama said, if you can't help me, please don't stop me. I got a race to run, and I'm running by faith. Paul says, I just want to know him. And let me ask you a question. Do y'all know who him is? Him's Abel's vindicator. Him's Joe's horror point at the valley. Him is Ezekiel's wheel in the middle of the wheel. Him is like fire shut up in my bones. Him is the fourth man in the fiery furnace. Him is Daniel Peace in the lion's den. Him is Abel's plumb line. Him is all I need. Ain't nobody talking to me. I thought y'all knew who him. Him is Matthew's king. Him is Mark's servant. Him is Luke's great physician. Him is John Word made flesh. Him is Acts come to the Holy Ghost. Do you know him?
Paul
said, I just want to know him. And when you get to know him, he'll make your burdens lighter. Him will have your feet lighter. Him will have you clapping your hands and ain't no music playing. Him will have you crying and ain't nobody did nothing to you. Him will have you waving your hands. Is there anybody that know him? That's a good place to close right there. Knowing him. Let me give you the third point, but I'm still happy off him. The third point is letting the prize be our goal. But let me tell you some more about him. My mind just jumped to Jude 24 and 25. Now unto him who is able to keep you from. And I don't know how you feel about it, but you need to know something about him. When your money gets funny, your change gets strange, you got to learn how to call on him. Him will show up in your sick room. Him will show up in your bedroom. Is there anybody here ever had to call on them when your body was racking with pain? Is there anybody here that had to call on them when your children weren't acting right? Is there anybody here that had to call on him when people left you alone? And I'm so glad that him never left me. Is there anybody here that know he won't leave you, nor will he forsake you? I'm so glad that my grandmama put me in the hands of him. I remember when I was on my way to hell, getting kicked out of school, getting sent home every day. My grandmama said, whooping you ain't gonna help, so I'm gonna put you in the hands of the Lord. And I don't know about you, but a year later, something started changing in my life. Instead of getting kicked out, I became mentors for the same folks that I talked about. I became a mentor for children getting kicked out of school, all because she put me in the hands of him. And I don't know how you feel about it, Mount Hermon, but I done put y'all in him hand. You can fight me all you want to, you can lie on me all you want, but I'm gonna put you in him hands, and he will work it out. Is there anybody here know he'll work it out? That problem that you have, he'll work it out. Those children, he'll work it out. Is there anybody here that want him to work it out? Well, let me tell you about him. He came down through 42 generations, born in a little town called Bethlehem, Judea. He raised Lazarus from the dead, fed 5,000 hungry souls he fed. Him gave sight to the blind. Him raised up sick folks, but he died. Is there anybody here that know he died? But early, oh shucks, early Sunday morning, he got up with all power in his hands. Is there anybody here know he's alive? Is there anybody here know he'll walk with you? He'll talk with you. Is there anybody here that can sit on your bed and have a little talk with Jesus? Tell him all about your trouble. Won't he hear your famous cry? Won't he answer by and by? Can't you feel the prayer real stirring? Don't you know the fire is burning? Ain't he all right? Ain't he all right? Say, ah! Oh, shucks. Yeah! Ah, yeah! Ah, yeah! Ain't he all right? Ain't he all right? Say, ah! Say, yeah! Say, ah! Now unto him who is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all you can ask or think. God, thank you. Thank you for sending your darling son Jesus. Now, God, we heard the word. Let us be doers of the word. There may be somebody here who don't know you in the part of their sins. Somebody might need to come for restoration. Candidate for baptism. Work on their hearts. Work on their minds. The doors of the church is open.